Hello everyone, welcome to Apigee Edge 4-Minute Videos for Developers, API Traffic Management Quota Series. In this video, we're going to see how Quota Policy Flow Variable works. Myself, Arun Sagar, I work at Google on Apigee platform. Prerequisites for this video, you need an Apigee Edge account. You can register at apigee.com/edge. You need basic understanding of Apigee Edge Quota Policy. For that, you can refer earlier 4-Minute Videos. When our API request goes through Apigee Edge, we can implement policies like quota and enforce API restrictions. Whenever a quota policy gets executed, it will set flow variables that we can consume in other policies. For example, we can see how much quota is available and how much quota has been used and what is the total count. We can use these flow variables further down the line. For example, in the response, we can let the developer know how much quota is available, how much quota has been used by that particular developer. Let's see this in action and how it works in Apigee Edge. Log into your Apigee Edge account by navigating to apigee.com/edge. Make sure you select your organization. Click on API proxies to create a new API proxy to see flow variables of quota in action. Click on API proxy to create a new proxy. We're gonna create a proxy of no target type to demonstrate flow variables. I'm gonna name the proxy as quota flow variable demos. Click next. Choose authorization as pass through. Click next. And then choose the defaults. Click on build and deploy. Once the proxy is deployed, navigate to develop screen from the overview screen. And then we're gonna add the quota policy. Click on develop. To add a quota policy, click on preflow, then click on plus step, then choose the quota policy. Let's update this quota policy to enforce quota of 4 API calls per minute. I'm gonna remove the calendar type. I'm gonna say allow count as 4 and the interval as 1 per minute. Change the time unit to minute. Change the distributed to true and synchronous to true. And remove start time and asynchronous configuration. Save the proxy to see quota in action. Click on trace and click on start registration. Make few API calls. As you can see, after the fourth call, it will give 500 and error saying rate limit quota violation. For the success calls, Apigee Edge doesn't give any response because we created a proxy of no target type. Let's leverage the flow variables. As you can see here in the trace, when you click on the policy, you can see the variables like allowed count and then available count and then used count. So we're gonna leverage these flow variables to display response message, how many are available, how many are consumed. For that, we're gonna use assign message policy. Click on develop back, click on plus step in the preflow response and add assign message policy. I have assign message policy here in the text editor, which is very simple. All it does is it sets a payload quota available and it uses the flow variable, which is set by the quota policy. As you can see, rate limit dot policy name dot available count, rate limit dot policy name dot used count. Let's save this proxy and let's see it in action. So let's go to trace, start the trace session. I'm gonna make the call using the browser. As you can see, it says quota available 3 and quota used 1. And you can see same. And when I make next call, it'll say quota available 2, quota used 2. And quota available 1 and quota used 3. Quota available 0 and quota used 4. Now it'll error out saying that rate limit quota violation. So that's how the flow variable you can consume set by the quota policy in different policies. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to post your questions in community.apigee.com. Subscribe to YouTube channel to get notifications whenever there's a new 4-minute video is published. Thank you for watching this video.